my pleasure.
So we're really interested in your whole transition from WUSA now to the WPS. So we're going to ask you a couple questions just in that area. Okay. So coming up, you have 4 games in 10 days, and that's pretty crazy. And you're bouncing back from a loss. And we're wondering what you're trying to accomplish in these 2 weeks.
Well, there's a lot of things to accomplish, but we have to build some confidence.
Yeah.
We need to do a little bit of tactical work. Like, I was just working with the defense to make sure we're on the same page, because our game against New Jersey, we lost 2-1, we weren't good defensively. And it was our organization and defense, so I have to take some responsibility in that. And then we're looking to get a little bit more quality in front of goal. Okay, there's really one thing this team needs right now, in addition to fine-tuning, and that is the ability to score late goals. Late goals would turn our ties into wins and our losses into ties.
What made you come back? We understand you have a strong relationship with your wife and kids. You must have had a lot of love towards women's soccer.
Well, yeah, I left after, an Olympic gold medal and a World Cup championship. I left the national team for him because I was just away from home too much. And I have 4 sons, and now they were probably about your age. Now they're a little bit older, although, how old are you guys? 14. Okay, my youngest now is 17, so he's just graduating high school. So it was just important for me to be home. Yeah, and they're all soccer players. A couple are still playing, and a couple are now coaching and whatever. So family's pretty important to me.
And what do you think is different about this generation?
Does anybody want any more of this case? Want more water?
Well, for sure, there's a different... there's a different look to the champion. The champion now, and it's because of women's athletics and because specifically of Title IX that made equal amounts of money spent on not just sports, but science or whatever, on girls as well as boys. So now the look of the champion now is got some female influence. It's a little bit more compassionate. It's a little bit more empathetic. There's more communication. The look of the champion when I was your age was kind of this macho guy, that chewed tobacco, and it's changed. And I think it's changed because of the influence of female athletes.
Okay. And finally, do you have any advice for young women athletes who want to make the team?
Well, it's I guess the best advice is it's not about talent. In my life, there's been so many talented people that come up short. It's really about perseverance, having goals and dreams and visions, and then having an action plan on how to achieve that. So if you want to reach the elite levels in any discipline, whether it's soccer or science or the medical profession, you need to follow your dreams and you need to put yourself around the best so you can emulate what they do.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, ladies. Thank you. Good pounds and stay fit. And so it was actually 2 bikes in there. My wife has her bike in there now, but I go back and forth from work.
Does it help just to clear some things
absolutely.
Up?
Absolutely. It feels like you did something for yourself, Because when I run now, my Achilles just really acts up. So I've been running, but I have to take too many days off between running, so I figured the bike is the next best thing.
Right. Interesting. Okay. We're big proponents of bicycles and wearing school and getting around and,
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
All right.